Hello students, welcome back to 9th session on regression analysis. Again in this session we are concentrating on either constructing equation or arriving at what they ask. See, in the previous problem we just concentrated on arriving at mean, we arrived at correlation coefficient and we arrived at standard deviation based on equation given in the problem. So sometimes they ask us to construct the equation, or sometimes they give equation and they ask us to calculate either arithmetic mean or standard deviation or correlation coefficient. So let me look at the problem. We just look at illustration 13.12. What is given? Arithmetic mean is given, standard deviation is given, and R between production and price is given. So when we have arithmetic mean, standard deviation, and R means correlation coefficient of production index and price index. So what they we have to put it symbolically. So arithmetic mean of production index, taking production index as X, so X bar 110. Price index, taking price index as Y, arithmetic mean symbolically represent Y bar, which is 98. Standard deviation, so standard deviation of X is 12, standard deviation of Y is 5. R, so means correlation coefficient. So RXY is equal to -0.4. So when they are not giving symbolically, we have to present given information symbolically. Then we should look at what they asked. Write down the regression equation price on production and calculate price index when the production index is 116. We have already taken production as X and price as Y. They asked us to come out with equation price on production. So means Y on X. So we should arrive at Y on X equation, regression equation. And we have to calculate price, that is Y, when production is 160. So when they asked us to calculate Y, when X is given, so we should make use of Y on X equation. First, we will have Y on X equation. Symbolically, we know Y minus Y bar is equal to BYX into X minus X bar. So what is BYX? BYX is regression coefficient X on Y, which is equal to R into standard deviation, Y divided by standard deviation X. So now, Y minus Y bar already given in the problem as 98 is equal to R, they have given 0.4 into standard deviation Y 98 divided by standard deviation X 110 into X minus 110, which is X bar. So when we simplify, it will become Y minus 98 is equal to -0.4 into 0.42 into X minus 110. So Y minus 98 is equal to 0.168 X minus 110. So Y minus 98 is equal to 0.168X minus into minus plus 18.48. So Y is equal to minus 0.168X plus 18.48 plus 98. We are taking 98 to the right hand side. So then Y will become 0.168X plus 116.48. So this is what equation Y on X. Now they had given X. X as how much? 116. So let me use a value of X in the equation Y on X. So Y is equal to minus 0.168 into 116 plus 116.48. The answer is 97. So when X, that is production, is 116, the price index will become 97. So with the help of R, standard deviation, and arithmetic mean of X and Y, we arrived at equation X, Y on X, and even we calculated value of Y when X is 116. In the same way, we can arrive at Y on X on Y, and we can calculate value of X when they are giving value of Y. So now let me move towards next problem. You are given the following results of height and weight of 1000 workers of a factory. X bar is 68, two dots. What is two dots indicates? 68 inches. So they have taken X as height. So 68 inches. You just look at this. After 68, you have two dots. So which indicates what? Which indicate inches. So standard deviation of X 2.5 inches. Y bar 150 IBS. It means 150 pound. Standard deviation of Y 20 IBS means 20 pound, because IBS is similar to pound. R is equal to 0.6. What information we had in the previous problem, here also we have the same information. In previous information, what is X bar, what is Y bar was explained under particular column in the given table. Here it is not given. X bar means standard deviation of height. Y bar means standard deviation of weight. R means correlation coefficient between height and weight. Next one, what is that term? Y bar. Y bar means arithmetic mean of weight. X bar means arithmetic mean of height. So here height is given in terms of inches. What they asked, from the above data, calculate the weight of particular factory worker who is 5'1" dot tall. Whenever they are giving one dot, it is in terms of feet. Means who is 5 feet tall. See, with regard to height, all are given in terms of inches, not in terms of feet. But when they are asking the question, they have given the height in terms of feet. So when they are giving in terms of feet, first we have to convert it to inches. So 1 foot is equal to 12 inches. So that's why 5 into 12 will become 60 inches. See, X is height. X bar means arithmetic mean of height. Arithmetic mean of height is 68. After 68, two dots are there. It means inches. Here, 5, after 5, 1 dot is there. It means feet. So, we have to calculate weight, that is Y. When height is 5 feet, all relating to X are given in terms of inches, not in terms of feet. So, what we have to do is, we have to convert this feet into inches. We know that 1 foot is equal to 12 inches. So, 5 into 12 is equal to 60 inches. Means, we have to calculate weight of a particular factory worker whose height is 60 inches. Did you get my point? Why we converted everything in inches? As we considered height as X, as they have said that we should consider height as X. All information relating to X are in inches. In the question, they said that we have to calculate Y when X is 5 feet, not in inches. So, we have to convert first that height into inches. So, afterwards, we should apply the formula. As far as next question is concerned, you just see the height of a particular factory worker whose weight is 20 IBS. So, definitely, as with regard to Y is concerned, all information given in the problem are in terms of IBS. Means it is in terms of what is that pound. Y bar is 150 pound. Standard deviation of Y is also 120 pound. Everything is in terms of pound. In question also they had given in terms of pound. We need not convert. When data relating to variable given in the problem is in terms of one measurement and given in the question is in terms of different measurement, so first we have to convert into common measurement. Here, as far as variable X is concerned, first they have given in terms of inches. Next they have asked calculate weight when height is 5 feet. When the height is not in common measurement, first you have to convert it to common measurement. So 1 foot is equal to 12 inches. So 12 into 5, because it is 5 feet high. So 12 into 5 will become 60 inches. But with regard to weight, everything is given in terms of IBS. So IBS means pound. So we need not convert it to common measurement. It is already in common measurement. So now, what and all information we have in the last problem, here also we have, but we will get confused with regard to that height, because 58 dot dot, two dots are given. It means, what is that? inches. 5-1 dart. It means what? It is fit. So that is what you should take care of. So now applying the formula. So we have to calculate weight means y. So we should construct first regression equation y on x. So regression equation y on x is equal to y minus y bar in is equal to r into standard deviation y divided by standard deviation x into x minus yx bar. So apply what and all value you know to the given equation, to this equation y on x, you will arrive y as 4.8x minus 176.4. Once we arrive the equation y on x, apply the value of x particularly in this equation. So x is equal to 5 feet. When we converted it to inches, it has become 60. So y is equal to 4.8 into 60 minus 176.4. The answer is 116.6. So when height is 5 feet or 60 inches, weight is 111.6 pounds. This is what the answer. Then they asked, what is weight? So what is height when weight is 200 pounds? So what is height when weight is 200? Height is x. So we should calculate height when weight is given. Means we should take care of equation x on y. So x minus x bar is equal to r into standard deviation x divided by standard deviation y into y minus y bar. Apply what and all given in the problem to this equation, then we will arrive equation as x is equal to 0.063y minus 58.55. Now we know the y is equal to 200. We need not convert it into common measurement because standard deviation of y is also in pounds, arithmetic mean of y is also in pounds, and they had given in question also in pounds. So, x is equal to 0.063 into y, that is 200, plus 558.5. The answer will become 71.15. When weight is 200, the height will become 71.15. So, this is all about this session. So, we will look at all these remaining problems particularly in last session of this chapter. So, we will see the remaining particularly in last session. Till that, take care of your health.